Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I've got another autumn glam look for you, or at least I feel like with the colors it sort of looks like autumn, but it could also just be a colorful eye look with a lot of shimmer. Either way, yeah, I don't know, I just felt like doing something fun and festive, and this is what we ended up with, so let's get started. Today we're going to go for a eye look based makeup tutorial again, like a little while back. I think last video actually, when this will be uploaded. But anyway, I actually did a get ready with me style video, like with the entire face. And then while editing, I remembered why I started doing eye look based videos. Because the other video was like 12 ages long. Oops. And I didn't even talk all that much. But yeah, anyway, so we're going to focus on the eye look today. I'm just priming my eyelids. And today I'm going to use the Heaps of Sweets palette by XO Beauty. Because I felt like using it again. Haven't used it in a while. Which side of the brush was I using? I don't remember. But anyway, so yeah. I have no idea what kind of look we're going to go for. As usual. But I think I want something more complicated. I don't know. We'll see. Another reason, by the way, why I wanted to use this palette is because she actually recently brought out a new palette. And I ordered it, but it won't actually ship until like halfway into November. And I live in the Netherlands, so it's probably going to be here somewhere in December. But yeah, anyway, I wanted to use this palette again. And also, I'm going to use a technique that I've been using a lot lately with a brush like... Well, actually, I used a piece of plastic, but I was cutting into my skin. And I've often seen Made You Look by Lex do it, like, well, Made You Look, and her name is Lex, point being, you know, if you watch her videos, you know who I mean, but she does it with a brush and then, you know, uses that to make a nice angled look. So, yeah, I figured, that looks a lot more friendly to the eye, so that's what we're gonna do today. So yeah, I'm just gonna pull you up a little bit closer so you can actually see what I'm doing. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is this, and if the whole lighting just seemed to have changed, well, that's because I closed my curtains, because we had the annoying problem again of sun, cloud, and me getting more and more frustrated from it. So yeah, we're only on artificial lighting now. It's a lot less irritating. That's the words. So yeah, anyway, I'm just going to... Well, basically, I want to do something purple. That's basically my entire idea, what the rest of the eyelid is going to look like. I don't even know. But I'm just going to gently put the brush against my face. I actually used this technique yesterday. Using a dense brush, by the way, to apply a lot of product here. But I actually used this technique yesterday when I was getting ready for work as a makeup artist. So obviously didn't have time to film it then. And then I figured out the hard way that I should not press the brush against my face too harshly, because I'm beyond the age where, you know, dents in your skin just, you know, disappear within 12 seconds. My skin is not that flexible anymore. I'm aging. So yeah, long story short, I figured I need to be a little bit more gentle and not actually press the brush through my skull. Just pressing it gently against my skin is basically enough. But yeah, anyway, I'm just applying that. And I'm going to go on to a darker purple shade. Obviously, if you don't have the Heaps of Sweets palette, just use other eyeshadows of the same color. And yeah, just going in with a smaller brush to really apply that on the outer part of the eye. And just blend it inwards. I'm not pulling this as far as I did with the other shade. That's something like this. And then it's just time to go into... One of my hairs was on the brush anyway. Actually, I'm going to wipe down this brush first. And then I'm going to blend the upper part of this a little. Because I don't want harsh lines. Basically, I apply it first and then I focus on the blending once I'm not, you know, awkwardly holding a brush to my face anymore. The brow bone highlight is going to be a shimmery shade because of the simple reason that there's no pale matte shade in this palette. And then I'm just going to go spend the next 12 hours blending the top part here. this is what I decided to do with the lid, and this time I'm doing it the official way. I'm just going back into my eye primer and actually cutting the crease first before doing anything else. Because I really want this to be a nice crisp edge, and you know, the shimmer eyeshadows on their own, they're not really going to completely cover the purple otherwise. So I'm just drawing the line, preferably somewhat even with the other eye. Like so. And then just blending that inwards. And because there's no eyeshadow obviously yet on this primer, it's also going to be extra sticky, so that also is going to help the shimmer eyeshadows to really, really pop. Yeah, just blending it outwards so we get a nice gradient there. I only want to cut crease effect on my inner corner. And then we're going to fill it in with gold, because I wanted to match my scarf thingy. It's actually a mask with like a skull on it. It's a tunnel scarf thing. You can also wear it as a headband and all. It's really cool. I might actually show it in this video if I don't forget. But if I forget, in my latest vlog when you're seeing this, or the vlog after that. Either the last vlog or the vlog that's still, you know, being filmed when you see this. Either one of those is going to contain footage of this particular scarf in its full glory. Like, I just love anything with skulls on it, and this one is just, wow, it's steampunk and it's so cool. But yeah, anyway, the eyeshadow, I'm just going to apply the gold over top of the eye primer I just applied, obviously. By the way, talk about like autumn makeup and stuff, and like autumn overall. At least here in the Netherlands, I don't know where you live and how it is in your country, of course. But at least here in the Netherlands, we're really going into the part of autumn where it's like dreary and like chilly and sort of rainy sometimes. And I love it, like seriously. I actually quite adore that part of autumn. I'm just switching to the other side of the brush, by the way, in a darker sort of coppery shade to blend the outer parts. But I just love that part of autumn. Like, I love dreary weather. I also like sunlight because things look gorgeous in the sunlight. But I really don't mind the chill in the air and just feeling that winter is coming. And I don't know, I just love the different seasons. So yeah, I'm actually quite enjoying myself with this weather. Like, this morning I went skating and then you're just going through the forest. And it's like all these beautifully colored leaves just coming down around you. And it's just so gorgeous. I love autumn. It's literally is my favorite season. Admittedly, the leaves on the ground are a little bit less nice when skating, because if you're not careful, you're going to slip over them. But yeah, you know, every fun thing has its challenges, let's just say that. But yeah, I just really, really love this time of year. Just to get that outer rim there a little bit more sparkly, I'm going into water with my eyeliner brush and then going into the really pale shimmer eyeshadow that I use beneath my brow bones. Just really, really coating the brush, and basically I'm just going to use it as a bit of an eyeliner. Just around the very rim of that shimmer part, eyelid part. You can see where I'm applying it, however you want to call it. And just blend it downwards a little, and then like the outer edges then is a little bit paler and is a little bit more sparkly, which I feel looks quite nice. And then time for eyeliner. And I am actually, you know, doing it the smart way and holding a mirror closer to my face, so I can actually see what I'm doing. And I think I'm going to go big today. As usual. Okay, so the eyeliner is on there. Surprisingly enough, it actually turned out the way I planned. It's a miracle. Anyway, I'm just going to quickly do my face off camera and then I'll return to you to finish the eyes. And the face is done. As always, everything I've used will be listed below the video in the description. But for now, we're just going to finish the eyes first. This is basically the idea for the under eye area. I'm going to start off with the side of a brush and the darker shade of purple. And I'm just going to use that to basically extend the wing to the bottom lid. I don't want to do a dark waterline this time around, so the darkness is going to have to come from the eyeshadow. but you always like it when the wings are just connected to the bottom. Then I'm going to go into small, tiny, fluffy blender and the shade of purple that was like a little bit paler. And I'm basically just extending the whole smokiness that we have going on here to the bottom side of the lid. Make sure to pull your skin nice and tight. Basically pull a very surprised face, that's always going to help. And just carefully blend it. You can always go over the wing again if you feel like the eyeshadow has made it paler. Okay, darkened up the wing again, and now I'm going to go into a liquid metal cream eyeshadow on a pencil brush, and I'm really carefully applying a teeny tiny bit of that in the inner corners as a highlight. Brands like Huda Beauty and Stila have this as well. I'm using Catrice Cosmetics because it also works and it's really, really cheap. But yeah, this is good. I'm just gonna give a really nice, you know, out there, very metallic highlight. Then eyelashes. I'm going to go for quite a big pair today because I feel like it. So yeah, this is the before. And after, this one is still drying, so I'm just applying lipstick. While I wait until I can put mascara over top of them. Yeah. Just a nude shade. And then for the lashes themselves, I'm just applying quite a lot, admittedly, on my lower lashes. And after that, a little bit on my top lashes, and after that, we'll be done. And we're left with the final results. Like promised, by the way, here is the scarf on its own. Again, I bought it at Lars.nl, which I think they sell internationally at emp.com. It's by Spiral at any rate, and it's really, really cool. Like, it's a skull. I love skulls. Why is it seeing a face here, my camera? That's weird. Anyway, I think it's really, really cool, and it'll also be very nice and cozy in winter. So yeah, and also it just looks cute as a scarf, I feel. I like it. Anyway, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. I do at least 2 makeup tutorials per week. And then 1 other video, which can be basically anything I feel like filming. Other than that, for today, thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!